Process chillers are not air conditioning chillers. Air conditioning chillers are designed to run at one specific temperature, flow rate, and fluid type. They do not have the flexibility of a process chiller to meet unique industrial process cooling needs. A process chiller can be applied to a variety of applications and can be customized to a facility's specific needs. There are two major parts of a process chiller, the refrigeration circuit and the process fluid circuit. The refrigeration circuit has four basic components: the condenser, metering device, an evaporator, which is also known as a heat exchanger, and the compressor. The compressor pumps the refrigerant gas from a low pressure to a high pressure. This high pressure, high temperature gas is then changed into a liquid in the condenser by removing heat energy from the refrigerant. The metering device reduces and regulates the pressure of the liquid refrigerant. The evaporator or heat exchanger takes advantage of the lower pressure and lower evaporation temperature to remove heat from the process fluid. Each of these components is selected by size and type to work efficiently to remove the amount of heat being produced and at the temperature required by the application. The process fluid circuit moves the cooling fluid through the process and is thermally connected to the refrigeration circuit at the evaporator or heat exchanger. The cooled process fluid is stored in a reservoir and pumped to the application, where the fluid removes its heat and flows back to the heat exchanger and chiller tank to continue the cycle. The process fluid will maintain a constant temperature and flow regardless of the heat load of the application. Some process circuits operate with multiple pumps, multiple cooling loops, or other unique components. Unlike an air conditioning chiller, a process chiller can be utilized in a wide range of different processes within a facility.